Hi, I'm Dr. Chavi Goldberg, and I founded CyberSEM. Last week, we began discussing the unique classroom challenges both teachers and parents are facing. Looking to alleviate the anxiety, the overall anxiety amongst teachers and their students is the topic for today. Karen Gross, from her book, Trauma Does Not Stop at the Classroom Door, describes the ranges of emotions and reactions she observed after 9/11, when her college students lost instructors, colleagues, and friends. In some students, she observed hostility, a lack of compliance, concentration, and memory. In others, she observed an over-regulation characterized by compliance beyond the norm, looking for more attention, students looking for more work to cover up, to substitute for what they were feeling. And still other students showed signs of isolation, preferring to sit alone, showing a lack of interest in academic and social activities, a quite large range. Educators need to recognize the signs of trauma in their students and start to calm them. One year I was teaching in Talpiot in Toronto. I taught lesson planning, and I felt that the first thing these budding students need to know was, who are these people sitting in front of them? So I asked my students, do you think that the children sitting in front of you today, seemingly all ready to learn, are they the same students that you had yesterday? And the correct answer to that is that they are not. I really felt so strongly that the teachers needed to be pre-warned of that, to be able to buy into that reality and that mindset, that students one day could be facing different traumas, different situations, different challenges. Even a simcha can bring different anxieties to a child that they did not face the day before. And so yes, the students sitting in front of them today may not be the same students that sat in front of you yesterday. I wanted my students to be aware of this truth. In these days of COVID, both teachers and students are in the same boat, and the students' traumas exacerbate the teachers' own traumas. The effects of the secondary trauma impacts the teachers' hope for the future, their ability to see that they are effective teachers, a feeling that they have a lack of purpose in the very profession they are engaged in. Finding peace in this extra level of trauma that teachers are experiencing, and perhaps parents are also experiencing, is difficult, but it's not impossible. The first solution is simcha. Next week, Emir Tashem, I will share a talk with you that I heard from Rabbi Sachs about the idea of simcha. He compares and he takes the model from Sefer Koheles, from the book of Koheles, and takes the message of simcha that we learn from Simchas Torah that we are taking now into the world with us. And that I found this particular talk so profound and so inspiring. And that's why I'd like to spend a little bit of time sharing the essence of that talk with you. Let me conclude by saying that self-care, reaching out to others, journaling are all good practice to put a teacher in a mindset of hopefulness and positivity. But the Jewish perspective of simcha, of a mindset that is healthy and positive, is proven to be one correct for all of mankind. To continue, please join me next week.